Now the software is, the server is started, and now we check the first our methods from our API. So the first method is a HTTP GET with show me all, show me a list of records. Then we have select one record, and then we have to update with a put. This is HTTP GET, HTTP GET with an ID, HTTP PUT with an ID. So we say API projects, and now this would be done as we've seen in our API projects, and now we get the JSON list back. Now we won't work with this one, as we said, we need the extension, the Chrome extension. We go on Chrome and we install Postman. Postman is a software which is on is in a Google extension. So when you go to the extensions, and you type in there Postman extensions, then you may download the tapped Postman REST client, and you may take some other further extensions if you have not downloaded it. Say Postman, and then download this one. Simply download it and add it to your application. As soon as you have added it to your application, to your Chrome, you will see, you will find it here as a block. And now we are able to test our API. So simply type in here the URL, and then that's the type of, here is the type of the protocol. So first we start with GET. Give me all my give me all my lists. So this is API projects. This one, API projects, is GET. So we are here, and then we say GET, we say send, and then we get a list. So this is the first one, and that's the return result is in JSON. And here's the status. The status is always when we come here, the project says return context result. Okay, it's not visible in here, but let's take the next one. We select one record because we want a definite text result record set. So we say in here put or get /1, and then we say send, then we get one record set. That's the record set of with the ID 1 and some URL text and title and text. And the status is 200 okay. So where does this come from? If you're that's the code which was defined by the template. Inside there, I modified it a little bit. We ask HTTP GET, so the system comes in here. We say send, now system comes in. Now there's the breakpoint. And our system comes in here in HTTP GET with an ID, so it matches in this method. Now we step through with the F10. We see here is GET project, there's the ID which comes in. So the ID is given by the /1. That's the /1. Then the model, if model state is valid, this is not important at that moment. So F10. Now we say from our context, from our database context, give me the table projects, single or default async one, from where in my model, table, my ID project is similar to, is equal to the ID which comes by the system. Now we go on and we will say, if there's if the project is null, then nothing is found. And then we say return OK. OK is given by, when we go there, this is given by the base controller, because here is OK result. Now when I go back, this is because the type is of type API controller. And in here it's only written as controller. In the other versions it's API controller in MVC5. So when we step on there, when we go on F5, then system gives back 200 OK. That's the result. And we get the project, this one by there. That's our model with the project. Here it is, models. That's the return value. So the return value is in the entire class and all those data sets. That's why we get this text in brackets, and the API controller converts it into JSON. JSON is given by this attribute in here, application JSON, so it translates it automatically. Now we test changing something. This is, now we have something, and my client, let's say in a WPF application or a smartphone, will update something. So we want to change it. So we go say get, and the opposite stuff is put. We put now something. Now we take this block and copy it into this area. We have to add the content type headers, application JSON header. And now we say title, for example, here now it's 10:14. And I say a breakpoint here on my method. Now I say send, and you see the breakpoint comes in here. And now the system has, this is my, I modified it, the template from Microsoft. Here's the project which is coming in. So I called it client project, because this is the data which are coming from my client. In here we see there is, that's the string which we got. There is title 10:14, so this is the actual time. Now the system checks if the model which we have there is valid, so it's okay. And now we say if the ID is the same as this ID. So when we are there with, if this ID is the same to this ID, then we will do something, we will go on. And now I say give me from my server my data, so server record set. So unfortunately it's called project at the moment, but it's a record set, server record set, await. So it's asynchronous, that's why we need here async. And we say context is my database, my table projects, single or default, give me the one where my ID, my project ID is the same. So I get a server project. Now that's a record set, a complete record set. At the moment there is 9:20 in there. And I will say if it's null, then give a break by that point. Otherwise, set the text which is coming in, my client data, to my server data, which is temporary in my by entity framework. This is on my IIS server now. It's a temporary table. Now I say okay, save it, and now at this moment it saves the complete record set to the SQL server. And then if it's done, we say return okay. Okay was that's the stuff. Bad gateway is now because it needed too much time. So we do it again. We say no breakpoint, don't wait there. F5. and now it's okay. And there's no result because it's only we said okay, okay, with no insight there, we are able to set project or any an object in there. If nothing is there, it's only okay. So we may also go to post project, which is create a new record set or delete a record set, and after this you are able to run your own client, so use it by a smartphone to get or set or send or put, delete, create, add some data by a smartphone or WPF application or an IoT small device.